today what we're focusing on is the freezer cleanup day. And essentially the idea is that we want to raise, one, awareness about the amount of energy consumed by these freezers, and two, we also want to promote the idea that people keep their freezers clean on a regular basis.
From the research that we've done, it looks like that some of these minus 80 freezers that we're using actually consume as much energy as an apartment or a house does per year. So they're incredibly inefficient. What can happen is, as the snow sort of builds up, the less free area in the freezer, that actually decreases the efficiency of the freezer. So if the freezer is totally packed with either ice or boxes of samples and stuff, it's actually running significantly less efficiently than if you have just layers of box where there's empty free space in it. So it's actually really important to knock out all the ice every once in a while. And then I'm sure, as you've seen, you stumble across samples that are years in past, so there's no reason to hold on to those anymore. So once those PhD students or individuals have finished their projects, you don't need those samples anymore, so they can be just safely disposed. The idea is to sort of switch to technologies that don't require ultra-low temperatures.
So it's not like where we have one freezer. We're talking about somewhere between 10 to 20 freezers per floor here in the McIntyre, and we have about 6 to 7 floors that are dedicated to research. So there's a significant number of freezers just within this research facility here. It's an issue that's moving to the forefront now, because there are technologies that are being developed where you can store some of your samples at room temperature, thus reducing the need for the amount of space that's presently reserved for this type of ultra-low temperature freezer. This is the first freezer cleanup day that we're hosting, and although so far we've only had about 10 labs, I think, that are participating at this point, we're hoping that we can make it a biannual event, so twice a year, because that's usually how many times you should clean your freezer, at least twice a year. And the idea is, as we go along, one, we're going to be raising awareness. People are going to start understanding the importance of considering how much energy is being consumed by these ultra low temperature freezers. But two, we're hoping to raise awareness about the actual space that a lab needs to store their samples. And so for our lab, I can say that now, being the first time that we're doing this, we used to have 3 shelves and an ultra low temperature freezer, and we've been able to reduce this down to a shelf and a half. And we're hoping, if you can continue this on a regular basis, that you'll use less storage, because you'll be more aware of which samples you're actually going to be using and which samples can be disposed of accordingly. And then eventually, hopefully, we'll raise awareness about our ultimate goal, which is to increase the use of room temperature storage in lab facilities here at McGill University, and also other upcoming technologies.